Hey learners, Pranshi Verma this side. Welcome to my channel guys. In today's YouTube session, we are going to discuss RCC Structures Design Multiple Choice Question and Answer. And guys, this is your civil branch subject. This video is very important for you. In this, your first question is, an RCC beam of 6 m span is 30 cm wide and has a lever arm of 55 cm if it carries a UDL. Uniform distributed load. Okay, UDL stands for uniform distributed load of 12 t per m, and allowable shear stress is 5 kg per semi square. The beam options are safe in shear, option B, the safe with strippers, option C, it's safe with strips and inclined bars, option D, need revision of section. So here right answer is option D, needs revision of section. Next question, according to IS 456, slabs which span is two directions with corners held down are assumed to be divided in each direction into middle strip and edge strip such that the width of the middle strip is, option A, half of the width of the slab, option B, 2/3 of the width of the slab, option C, 3/4 of the width of the slab, and option D, 4/5 of the width of the slab. Okay, so here right answer is option C, 3/4 of the width of the slab. Next question, the load stress of a section can be reduced by, option A, decreasing the lever arm, option B, increasing the total parameter of bars, option C, replacing larger bars by greater number of small bars, option D, replacing smaller bars by greater number of greater bars. Right answer here is option C, replacing larger bars by greater number of small bars. Okay, so the load stress of a section can be reduced by replacing larger bars by greater number of small bars. Next question, the diameter of the column head support a flat slab is generally kept, option A, 0.25 times the span length, option B, 0.25 times the diameter of the column, option C, 4.0 cm larger than the diameter of the column, option D, 5.0 cm larger than the diameter of the column. Right answer here is option A, 0.25 times the span length. Means the diameter of the column head support a flat slab is generally kept 0.25 times the span length. Next question, if W is the uniformly distributed load on a circular slab of radius R fixed at its end, the maximum positive radial moment as its center is, option A, 3 WR² / 16, option B, 2 WR² / 16, option C, WR² / 16, option D, none of these. Right answer is option C, WR² / 16. Next question, if the width of the foundation for two equal columns is restricted, the shape of the footing generally adopted is, option A, square, option B, rectangular, option C, trapezoidal, option D, triangular. Right answer here is option B, rectangular. If the width of the foundation for two equal columns is restricted, the shape of the footing generally adopted is rectangular. Okay. Next question. The floor slab of building is supported on reinforced cement floor beams. The ratio of the end and intermediate spans is kept, option A, 0.7, option B, 0.8, option C, 0.9. Option D, 0.6. Right answer is option C, 0.9. The floor slab of a building is supported on reinforced cement floor beams. The ratio of the end and intermediate spans is kept 0.9. Next question. Pick up the correct statement from the following. First statement is, lateral reinforcement in RCC columns is provided to prevent the longitudinal reinforcement from buckling. Next statement is, lateral reinforcement prevents the shearing of concrete on diagonal plane. Next statement is, lateral reinforcement stops breaking away of concrete cover due to buckling, and option D is all of the above. So here right answer is option D. Option D, all of the above, because option A means statement 1, option B statement 2, option C statement 3. They all are correct statement. Okay. So right answer is option D. Next question. In case the factor of safety against sliding is less than 1.5, a portion of slab is constructed downwards at the end of the heel slab, which is known as option A, a key, option B, a cutoff wall, option C, a rib, option D, all of the above. Right answer is option D, all of the above. Okay. In case of factor against sliding is less than 1.5. A portion of slab is constructed downwards at the end of the heel slab, which is known as a key and a cutoff wall and a rib. Right answer is option D. Next question. Left splices in tensile reinforcement are generally not used for bars of size larger than option A 18 mm diameter, option B 24 mm diameter, option C 30 mm diameter, option D 36 mm diameter. Right answer here is option D, 36 mm diameter. Left splices in tensile reinforcement are generally not used for bars of size larger than 36 mm diameter. Next question. Minimum spacing between horizontal parallel reinforcement of the same size should not be less than option A 1 diameter, option B 2.5 diameters, option C 3 diameters, option D 3.5 diameters. Right answer is option A 1 diameter. Minimum spacing between horizontal parallel reinforcement of the same size should not be less than 1 diameter. Okay. So, right answer here is option A. Next question. For a ribbed slab, option A, clear spacing between ribs shall not be greater than 4.5 cm. Option B, width of the rib shall not be less than 7.5 cm. Option C, overall depth of the slab shall not exceed 4 times the breadth of the rib, and option D, all of the above. Right answer here is option D, all of the above. Okay, because for a ribbed slab, clear spacing between ribs shall not be greater than 4.5 cm. This is correct one. And for a ribbed slab, width of the rib shall not be less than 7.5 cm is also correct one. And for a ribbed slab, overall depth of the slab shall not exceed 4 times the breadth of the rib. Okay, this one is also correct. So here right answer is option D. Next question. A very comfortable type of stairs is option A straight, option B dog-legged, option C geometrical, option D open navel. Right answer here is option D, open navel. Okay. A very comfortable type of stair is open navel. Next question. Columns may be made of plain concrete if their unsupported lengths do not exceed their least lateral dimensions. Option A 2 times, option B 3 times, option C 4 times, option D 5 times. Right answer is option C 4 times. Columns may be made of plain concrete if their unsupported length do not exceed their least lateral dimensions 4 times. Okay. Next question. The width of the flange of a L beam should be less than option A 1/6 of the effective span, option B breadth of the rib plus 4 times thickness of the slab, option C breadth of the rib plus half clear distance between ribs, option D least of the above. Right answer here is option D, least of the above. So the width of the flange of L beam should be less than least of the above. Okay. Next question. A pre-stressed concrete member is preferred because option A, its dimensions are not decided from the diagonal tensile stress. Option B, larger size of long beams carrying large shear force need not be adopted. Option C, removal of cracks in the members due to shrinkage. Option D, all of the above. Right answer is option D, all of the above. Okay. So a pre-stressed concrete member is preferred because due to option A, B and C. Next question. If the ratio of the span to the overall depth does not exceed 10, the stiffness of the beam will ordinary twice satisfactory in case of A. Options are option A, simply supported beam. Option B, continuous beam. Option C, cantilever beam. Option D, none of these. Right answer here is option C, cantilever beam. Okay. If the ratio of the span to the overall depth does not exceed 10, the stiffness of the beam will ordinarily be satisfactory in case of a cantilever beam. Next question. A piles of length L carrying a uniformly distributed load W per meter length is suspended at two points, the maximum BM at the center of the pile or at the points of suspension is option A, WL divided by 8, option B, WL square divided by 24, option C, WL square divided by 47, option D, WL square divided by 16. Right answer here is option C, WL square divided by 47. Okay, a pile of length L carrying a uniformly distributed load W per meter length is suspended at two points, the maximum BM at the center of the pile or at the points of suspension is WL square divided by 47, and this is very important question for your examination, guys. Next question. If P is the net upward pressure on a square footing of side B for a square column of side A, the maximum bending moment is given by option A, bending moment is equal to PB in bracket C minus A divided by 4. Option B, bending moment is equal to PB in bracket B minus A ka whole square divided by 4. Option C, BM is equal to PV in bracket B minus A ka whole square divided by 8. Option D, BM is equal to PB in bracket B plus A divided by 8. And here, right answer is option C. Bending moment means BM is equal to PB in bracket B minus A ka whole square divided by 8. Okay. Next question. To ensure uniform pressure distribution, the thickness of the foundation is option A, kept uniform throughout. Option B, increased gradually towards the edge. Option C, decreased gradually towards the edge. Option D, kept zero at the edge. Here, right answer is option C, decreased gradually towards the edge. Okay. To ensure uniform pressure distribution, the thickness of the foundation is decreased gradually towards the edge. Next question. According to load factor method, the permission load W on a short column reinforced with longitudinal bars and lateral strips is option A, stress in concrete multiply area of concrete. Option B, stress in steel multiply area of steel. Option C, stress in concrete multiply area of concrete plus stress in steel multiply area of steel. And option D, none of these. Right answer here is option C. So, according to load factor method, the permission load W on a short column reinforced with longitudinal bars and lateral strips is stress in concrete multiply area of concrete plus stress in steel multiply area of steel. Okay. Next question. If P1 and P2 are mutually perpendicular principal stresses acting on a soil mass, the normal stress on any plane inclined at angle theta degree to the principal plane carrying the principal stress P1 is, आपको options given है, option A, B, C, D, and here option C is right one. This is P1 plus P2 is divided by 2 plus P1 minus P2 is divided by 2 and overall multiply by cos 2 theta. Okay guys, kindly remember this formula. This is very, very important question and this is very important formula also. Okay, so right answer here is option C. Next question. The maximum permissible size of aggregates to be used in casting the ribs of a slab is option A 5 mm, option B 7.5 mm, option C 10 mm, option D 15 mm. Right answer here is option C 10 mm. Okay, the maximum permissible size of aggregates to be used in casting the ribs of a slab is 10 mm. Next question. Pick up the incorrect statement from the following, and here tensile reinforcement bars of a rectangular beam, option A, are curtailed if not required to resist the bending moment. Guys, listen to me very, very carefully. And यहाँ पर आपको incorrect statement choose करना है. Option B है यहाँ पे, are bent up at suitable places to serve as shear reinforcement. Next one. Are bent down at suitable places to serve as shear reinforcement. Next one, are maintained at bottom to provide at least local bond stress. Okay, right answer here is option C. Means यहाँ पर जो incorrect statement है वो है C. And this is, are bent down at suitable places to serve as shear reinforcement. Okay, so tensile reinforcement bar of a rectangular beam. Behalf of this sentence, the incorrect statement is option C. Next question. Steel bars are generally connected together to get greater length than the standard length by providing option A, a straight bar splice, option B, hooked splice, option C, double splice, option D, all of the above. Right answer here is option D, all of the above. Means, steel bars are generally connected together to get greater length than the standard length by providing a straight bar spline and hooked spline and double spline. Okay, next question. The minimum thickness of the cover at the end of a reinforcing bar should not be less than twice the diameter of the bar subjected to a minimum of option A 10 mm, option B 15 mm, option C 20 mm, option D 25 mm. Here right answer is option D 25 mm. The minimum thickness of the cover at the end of a reinforcing bar should not be less than twice the diameter of the bar subject to a minimum of 25 mm. Okay. Next question. Top bars are extended to the projecting parts of the combined footing of two columns L distance apart for a distance of option A 0.1 L from the outer edge of column. Option B 0.1 L from the center edge of column. Option C, half the distance of projection. Option D, 1/4 the distance of projection. Right answer here is option B, 0.1 L from the center edge of column. Okay. Top bars are extended to the projecting parts of the combined footing of two columns L distance apart for a distance of 0.1 L from the center edge of column. Next question. For M150 grade concrete 1:2:4, the moment of resistance factor is option A 0.87, option B 8.50, option C 7.50, Option D 5.80. And here right answer is option B 8.50. Okay, next question. P is the pre-stressed force applied to tendon of a rectangular pre-stressed beam whose area of cross-section is A and sectional modulus is Z. The minimum stress F on the beam subjected to a maximum bending moment M is option A, B, C, D given in upper, and here right option is option C. F is equal to in bracket P divided by A minus M divided by Z. Okay, and P, A, M, Z are their usual and respected meanings. Okay, next question. If C is creep coefficient, F is original pre-stress in concrete, M is modular ratio, E is Young's modulus of steel, and E is shrinkage strain. The combined effect of creep and shrinkage is, right answer here is option B, C minus 1 multiply MF plus small e multiply capital E. Okay. Next question. In a pre-stressed member, it's advisable to use option A low strength concrete only, option B high strength concrete only, option C low strength concrete but high tensile steel, option D high strength concrete and high tensile steel, and right answer here is option D high strength concrete and high tensile steel. In a pre-stressed member, it's advisable to use high strength concrete and high tensile steel. Next question. An RCC lintel is spanning an opening of 2 m span. In a brick wall, the height of the roof is 2.9 m above the floor level and that of the opening is 2.1 m above the floor level. This lintel is to be designed for self-weight plus option A, triangular load of the ball, option B, UDL of ball, option C, UDL of ball plus load from the roof, option D, triangular load plus load from the roof. Okay, so right answer here is option C, UDL of ball plus load from the roof. Okay, an RCC lintel is spanning an opening of 2 m span is brick wall, the height of the roof is 2.9 m above the floor level and the depth of the opening is 2.1 m above the floor level. The lintel is to be designed for self weight plus UDL of ball plus load from the roof. Next question. The minimum clear cover for RCC columns shall be option A greater of 40 mm or diameter, option B smaller of 40 mm of diameter, option C greater of 25 mm or diameter, option D smaller of 25 mm or diameter. Right answer here is option C greater of 25 mm or diameter. Next question. The minimum thickness of a flat slab is taken. Option A, L by 32 for end panels without drops. Option B, L by 36 for end panels without drops. Option C, L by 36 for interior panels without drops. Option D, all of the above. Here, right answer is option D, all of the above. Next question. The design of heel slab of a retaining wall is based on the maximum bending moment due to option A, its own weight, option B, weight of the soil above it, option C, load of the surcharge, if any, option D, all of the above. Right answer here is option D, all of the above. Next question. An RCC beam of 25 cm width has a clear span of 5 meters and carries a UDL, uniform distributed load of 2000 kg per meter inclusive of its self weight. If the lever arm of the section is 45 cm, the beam is option A safe in shear, option B if safe with strips, option C if safe with strippers and inclined members, ऑप्शन डी नीड्स रिवीजन ऑफ द सेक्शन. राइट आंसर इज ऑप्शन ए सेफ इन शियर. An RCC beam of 25 cm berth has a clear span of 5 meters and carries a UDL of 2000 kg per meter inclusive of its self weight. If the lever arm of the section is 45 cm, the beam is safe in shear. Next question. The neutral axis of a T beam exists, option A, within the flange, option B, at the bottom edge of the slab, option C, below the slab, option D, all of the above. Right answer here is option D, all of the above. Next question. A precast pile generally used is option A, circular, option B, square, option C, octagonal, option D, square with corners chamfered. And here right answer is option D, square with corners chamfered. Next question. The spacing of transverse reinforcement of column is decided by the following consideration. Option A, the least lateral dimensions of the column. Option B, 16 times the diameter of the smallest longitudinal reinforcing rods in the column. Option C, 48 times the diameter of transverse reinforcement. Option D, all of the above. Right answer is option D, all of the above. Okay. The spacing of transverse reinforcement of column is decided by the following consideration. Option A, B and C. Next question. The self weight of the footing is option A, not considered for calculating the upward pressure on footing. Option B, also considered for calculating the upward on footing. Option C, not considered for calculating the area of the footing. And option D, both V and C. Right answer here is option A, not considered for calculating the upward pressure on footing. The self weight of the footing is not considered for calculating the upward pressure on footing. Next question. Pick up the incorrect statement from the following. Option A, in the steam of a retaining ball, reinforcement is provided near the earth side. Option B, in the toy slab of a retaining ball, reinforcement is provided at the bottom of the slab. Option C, in the heel slab of a retaining ball, reinforcement is provided at the top of the slab. Option D, none of these. Right answer here is option D, none of these. Means here, option A, B, C, they all are correct statement and no incorrect statement are available in their options. So right answer is option D. Next question. If the wearing capacity of soils is 10 tons per semi square and the projection of plain concrete footing from bars is a semi, the depth D of footing is option A, D is equal to 0.0775A. Option B, D is equal to 0.775A. Option C, D is equal to 0.775 under root A. And option C, D is equal to 0.775A square. Right answer is option B, D is equal to 0.775 multiplied by A. If the wearing capacity of soils is 10 tons per semi square and the projection of plane concrete footing from bars is a semi, the depth D of footing is D is equal to 0.775A. Next question. After pre-stressing process is completed, a loss of stress is due to option A, shrinkage of concrete, option B, elastic shortening of concrete, option C, creep of concrete, option D, all of the above. Right answer is option D, all of the above. Okay, so the option are A, B, C are included in it. Next question. If a simply supported slab, alternate bars are curtailed at option A, 1/4 of the span, option B, 1/5 of the span, option C, 1/6 of the span, option D, 1/7 of the span. Right answer here is option D, 1/7 of the span. In a simply supported slab, alternate bars are curtailed at 1/7 of the span. Next question. If R and T are rise and tread of a stair is spinning horizontally, the steps are supported by a wall on one side and by a stringer beam on the other side. The steps are designed as beam of width. Option A, R plus T. Option B, T minus R. Option C, under root R square plus T square. Option D, R minus T. Here, right answer is option C, under root R square plus T square. Okay, this is very important question, guys. If R and T are rise and tread of a stair spanning horizontally, the steps are supported by a wall on one side and by a stringer beam on the other side. The steps are designed as beam of width under root R square plus T square. Next question. Next question is also very important one. If P1 and P2 are effective lateral loadings at the bottom and top exerted by a level earth subjected to a super load on the vertical face of height h of a retaining ball, the horizontal pressure P per unit length of the wall is, right answer here is option C, in bracket P plus P2 divided by 2 and overall multiply by h. Okay. Next question. If the zone of RCC beam where shear stress is less than 5 kg per semi square, nominal reinforcement is provided at a pitch of option A, 1/2 label arm of the section, option B, 1/3 label arm of the section, option C, lever arm of the section, option D, 1/2 lever arm of the section. Right answer here is option C, lever arm of the section. If the zone of RCC beam where shear stress is less than 5 kg per semi square, nominal reinforcement is provided at a pitch of lever arm of the section. Next question. The traverse reinforcement provided at right angles to the main reinforcement, option A, distribute the load, option B, resist the temperature stresses, option C, resist the shrinkage stress, option D, all of the above. Right answer is option D, all of the above. Okay, next question. Long and short spans of a 2B slabs are IY and IX are load on the slab acting on strips parallel to LX and LY be WX and WY respectively. According to Rankine-Grashof's theory, option A, B, C, D are given here, and right answer is option C. WX divided by WY is equal to LY divided by LX, and overall key power 4. Okay, so right answer here is option C, and this is very, very important question, guys. Okay guys, now let's wind up the lecture. See you in the next video. Thanks for watching this video. Wish you very, very all the best for examination. Thank you.